What happens when engineers throw practicality out the window and build tractors with more horsepower than a tank? Touchscreens like a Tesla, or get this, two engines running side by side. These aren't just tractors, they're mechanical beasts that went way beyond what farmers actually needed. Buckle up, because you're about to see the 10 most insanely over-engineered tractors ever made. Number 1. Big Bud, 16V747. If there's one tractor that deserves the title of most over-engineered, it's the Big Bud 16V747. Built in 1977 by Northern Manufacturing Company of Montana, this tractor was custom designed for the Rossi brothers, who needed a machine capable of deep ripping over 3,000 acres of land, and what they got was a behemoth that stood 14 feet tall, 27 feet long, and weighed a staggering 100,000 pounds when fully ballasted. At the heart of this monster is a 16-cylinder Detroit diesel engine that produces over 1,100 horsepower. An unimaginable number for agricultural equipment at the time. The tractor is equipped with a 1,000-gallon fuel tank and runs on custom-built Titan Goodyear tires, over 8 feet tall. The sheer scale of its components, its axles, transmission, and cooling system, all come from the mining and construction sectors. While undeniably powerful and effective for massive operations, the Big Bud 747 was wildly impractical for most farms. It's a prime example of engineering without limitations, and only one was ever built, securing its place as an icon of agricultural excess. Number 2. Versatile 1150. In the 1970s, Versatile, a Canadian tractor company known for its innovative designs, sought to tackle high horsepower demands by using two V8 engines side by side in a single machine. The result was the Versatile 1150, a four-wheel drive tractor capable of over 600 horsepower, an astronomical number for its time. The two Cummins V8 engines were mounted parallel and connected through a shared driveline system. This layout provided immense torque and power, but introduced a host of problems. Keeping both engines in sync was a challenge. If one engine lagged or failed, it affected the whole system. Operators had to monitor fuel consumption, oil pressure, and temperature for both engines separately. Furthermore, the complexity of the linkage between the two power plants made routine maintenance a mechanic's nightmare. While it delivered unmatched pulling power, the 1150 proved to be too complex for most operators, and the twin-engine concept faded into obscurity, proving that sometimes one engine is more than enough. Number 3. John Deere 8850. John Deere, the American farming giant, took a bold step in the early 1980s with the release of the 8850, a tractor powered by a 955 cubic inch V8 diesel engine. Most tractors at the time relied on simpler inline-six configurations, but Deere aimed to pack more punch into a compact form. Unfortunately, the 8850's V8 design brought with it significant challenges. The large engine created excessive heat, and the tractor's cooling system often struggled under load. Cracked engine blocks became a recurring issue, and mechanics found it difficult to access internal components due to the compact V-shaped engine bay. What was supposed to be a powerhouse of innovation ended up being costly and unreliable for many farmers. Though powerful and commanding in appearance, the 8850 is now remembered more for its mechanical issues than its performance. It's a cautionary tale of how even trusted manufacturers can go too far in pursuit of innovation. Number 4. Lamborghini DL30C. Many people are surprised to learn that Lamborghini, famous for its supercars, began its journey by making tractors. One of its most technically ambitious models was the DL30C, a machine that embodied the essence of Italian engineering and style, but in a field-ready package. The DL30C was equipped with a high-revving diesel engine, a multi-speed PTO, and precision-crafted parts that were designed with the same meticulous care as a luxury automobile. Everything from the gauges to the transmission components felt more like they belonged in a sports car than a rugged workhorse. Though it was undeniably elegant and ahead of its time, the DL30C was simply too expensive and delicate for the average farmer. Maintenance required specific knowledge, and spare parts were not easily accessible. Its over-engineered nature made it impractical in the field, proving that while Italian flair is excellent on a racetrack, it doesn't always belong in a cornfield. Number 5. Case IH Steiger, Quadtrac 620. The Case IH Quadtrac 620 is a modern marvel, a tractor that brings together raw power and high-tech intelligence. With a 15-liter six-cylinder engine capable of producing 692 horsepower, this machine is built to handle the most demanding agricultural tasks. But it's not just about power. The Quadtrac uses four independent rubber tracks instead of traditional wheels, allowing it to minimize soil compaction while maintaining incredible traction. It also features precision GPS systems, real-time data tracking, touchscreen displays, and automated field mapping. While perfect for industrial-scale farms, its complexity makes it intimidating for small to mid-sized operations. Diagnostics often require specialized software and technicians. Farmers now have to understand both diesel mechanics and digital systems, a significant shift from the wrench and oil days. Though highly capable, the Quadtrac 620 arguably represents a level of technological complexity that outpaces the needs of many agricultural businesses. Number 6. Mercedes-Benz MB Track. When Mercedes-Benz entered the agricultural market with the MB Track series, they brought with them a commitment to precision, comfort, and innovation. Produced from the 1970s to the 1990s, MB Tracks featured symmetrical four-wheel drive, automotive-grade interiors, and high-end materials throughout. These tractors were built for multi-purpose use. Whether in municipal snow clearing, forestry, or farming, they were designed to perform reliably in all terrains. The cab design was luxurious by tractor standards, offering air suspension seats, climate control, and Mercedes dashboards, a stark contrast to the bare-bones interiors of their contemporaries. However, this level of refinement came at a cost. MB Tracks were significantly more expensive than competitors and difficult to service due to their unique design. Parts were costly, and trained service centers were limited. Although these machines were a joy to operate, they were simply over-engineered for basic agricultural work. Number 7. DOED. Perhaps the most unusual tractor on this list is the DOED, short for double drive. This British invention from the 1950s involved joining two Fordson tractors back-to-back, removing the front wheels of each, and connecting their steering and power systems to create one synchronized articulated tractor. The goal was simple, double the power, without having to develop a new high-horsepower engine. And in a time when technology was limited, it worked surprisingly well. The DOED was capable of pulling massive equipment that no single tractor could handle. However, the drawbacks were plenty. The operator had to manage two engines simultaneously, which meant double the maintenance, double the fuel consumption, and double the potential breakdowns. Steering was awkward, visibility was poor, and synchronization required constant attention. It was a clever solution to a power problem, but one that quickly became obsolete as true high-horsepower tractors entered the market. Number 8. Valtra S Series with Smart Touch. Valtra, a Finnish tractor brand, introduced the Smart Touch system in its S Series tractors, ushering in a new age of tractor operation. This system includes a touchscreen display, customizable joystick controls, and programmable hydraulic flow rates, turning the tractor into a fully digital machine. The tractor learns user preferences, offers GPS navigation, allows the operator to save task profiles, and can even be controlled remotely for diagnostics. This tech-centric approach increases efficiency and productivity on paper. However, the downside is its dependence on electronics. Diagnosing a broken valve or switch isn't as simple as turning a wrench. It requires a laptop and specialized knowledge. For older farmers or those without access to tech support, the S-Series can be overwhelming. It's a brilliant tool for precision agriculture, but arguably too complicated for those who just want to plow a field. Number 9. Fendt 1000 Vario. The Fendt 1000 Vario series is widely considered the Ferrari of the tractor world. These tractors feature continuously variable transmissions, CVTs, sub-inch GPS auto steering, and real-time data transmission. They can reach speeds of up to 60 km per hour faster than many small cars. Inside the cab, operators enjoy touchscreen dashboards, air ride suspension seats, and 360-degree cameras. Every component is engineered to the highest standards of German manufacturing. However, all this performance and comfort come with an enormous price tag, easily exceeding $500,000. Repairs require factory-level service centers, and insurance costs can rival commercial trucks. It's an engineering masterpiece, no doubt, but it represents a level of over-engineering that few farmers truly need or can afford. Number 10. Ford FW60. The Ford FW60 is another example of raw power meeting excessive design. Introduced in the late 1970s, this 4WD tractor was designed for massive American farms and was powered by a 14-liter Cummins engine, delivering over 400 horsepower. With oversized axles, a reinforced steel frame, and industrial-grade components, it was built like a tank. Everything about the FW60 screamed power, but also weight, fuel consumption, and bulkiness. It was a poor fit for smaller or diversified farms and guzzled fuel at an unsustainable rate. While the tractor gained a loyal following for its toughness, it ultimately became an icon of inefficient design. Overbuilt for most agricultural tasks, the FW60 serves as a reminder that durability should be balanced with practicality. From twin-engine monsters to touchscreen supertractors, these machines show just how far engineering can go, sometimes too far. Which one blew your mind the most? Let us know in the comments. And if you're obsessed with farming tech, don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and ring that bell for more jaw-dropping tractor content every week. Until next time, stay powerful, stay curious,